Modern Wahine Hawaii is presented by Inspiration Interiors, home fashion with an attitude. I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii.
Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. We've got quite a sporty show for you today, and it starts in, of all places, the Hawaii Convention Center. We went down to catch up with General Manager Terry Orton to see all the innovative ideas she's been implementing. Take a look. Aloha, everybody. I'm here at the Hawaii Convention Center with Terry Orton, General Manager. Hi, Terry. How are you?
Good. How are you, Brooke?
Thank you for inviting me into your home away from home here.
You're welcome. It's Thank you for joining us.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
So let's talk about how you got involved in becoming the GM here at the Convention Center.
Well, my background is hotel. I've been everywhere from front desk to reservations to director of operations to general manager. Spent 17 years of my career with Starwood Hotels Hawaii, then most recently with Outrigger Hotels, and had this wonderful opportunity to manage this beautiful building, and decided that, you know, I knew that I could make a difference here, and that's why I took the job. And I've never regretted the position since I've been on board. I've been here for 5.5 years now and have enjoyed every minute.
So since you've come on board at the Hawaii Convention Center, because I have a little bit of history with the Convention Center, because when I gave it the title, it was brand new in 1998. And you know, it was a big deal to have a convention center here. Since its tenure in 98 and when you came in 5.5 years ago, you kind of wanted to change things up a little bit, didn't you, with the convention center? What was your vision when you came on board?
I really wanted to put the customer first and really elevate the customer's experience here at the convention center. So I thought to myself, why would we not give them the little vignettes that they needed to do business? And as you can see, we've put in new furniture package here at the convention center and created little areas for small meetings so that when they would break out of session, they could plug in their computer and sit on a chair and conduct business, whether it's a conference call or check emails, and just enhance the overall meeting experience here. We've put in charging stations and little areas where people can just disconnect and take a moment to regroup before stepping back into session. And those are just some of the improvements that we've done here at the Convention Center, is really trying to elevate the service and the amenities that we provide to our attendees. And giving them that world-class experience they expect.
I mean, it really does feel homey when you come here. You know, most convention centers are so like large scale sort of places you go, you have a meeting, you leave, but it really feels very homey here. And besides all of the convention work that comes here, you have made it kind of a point to make sure that you give back to the community and that you make sure that Hawaii feels like this is their convention center as well. What are some of your ideas about that?
There are members of my family that have never stepped into this building. They have no reason to come here if they're not coming to a conference or a meeting. And I felt like, wow, this is such a huge building and such an icon in our community that every local should feel like they have been here and that this is a place that they can come, whether it's to do business or for a party or reception. So we took it upon ourselves, our team, to start to create local events here. So we most recently bought the Okinawan Festival from Kapi'olani Park over here. We're looking at doing more local concerts and events. We have our Sunset Mele that happens twice a year now, where we basically bring local artists into our building to entertain and invite the community, whether it's crafters to come in and sell their crafts, and invite our local ohana from all over the state, even neighbor islands, to come and share in that experience here at the Hawaii Convention Center.
That's so awesome. So also, as being part of Hawaii and, you know, Malamata Aina, you think of big buildings, you think that, you know, there's a big resources being taken from the community here, but it's very important to you, especially since you've been here, to give back to Hawaii and to start sustainability initiatives here, right?
Absolutely.
Let's talk about that.
So, you know, I feel as a leader in our industry that it really truly is our responsibility to make sure that we take care of the resources that we have here that is so generously giving to us and to all of our visitors. I mean, our beaches and our mountains and doing business here, it's our responsibilities as leaders to make sure that we preserve that so that generations that come after us have the same beauty to enjoy that we have today. And so we've taken it upon ourselves here, our team collectively, because it takes a village to do these kind of things, is look through a different lens, a green lens, so to speak, to make sure that we're just doing everything we possibly can to be responsible and to preserve our natural environment.
So I saw you guys do like a core tree project. You want to talk about that?
Yeah, so we recently partnered with Hawaii Legacy Reforestation Initiative. It's a reforestation initiative that takes place on the Big Island up at Mauna Kea. And also here, they just purchased or actually have a lease agreement out at Malaikahana, and they're starting a reforestation project there. We've put together a package where every meeting planner that plans a meeting in our building, we offer them this opportunity. It's a turnkey opportunity to give back to our natural resources here and preserve the resources that we have here in Hawaii by planting trees and reforesting.
So it's not always work, work, work here. There's also a little bit of fun to be had. We're gonna get on some tricycles, is that what I'm hearing?
Yes, it's how I commute in between meetings here in our 1 million square foot building.
So we're gonna get on some bikes and maybe play some basketball?
Maybe.
Okay, let's go. When we come back, Terry and I go head to head on the basketball court in heels, shooting hoops. You're gonna wanna see it. Okay, so we're here in the sports area. And this is something that was your baby, right? Bringing sports to a convention center.
Yes, so we weren't in the game of sports here in Hawaii all under one roof. I had an opportunity to go to California to watch a volleyball tournament at the Los Angeles Convention Center. And I was actually really amazed to see thousands of families there to watch their kids play in a tournament. And I thought, what better opportunity than to come to Hawaii, bring your kids here, watch them play sports, and spin it off to a pre and post vacation, neighbor islands or on Oahu. So I did some research and actually convinced Hawaii Tourism Authority to allow me to spend $1.1 million on sporting equipment that we have here in our convention center. And then I freaked out. I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get a tournament on the books. So I was fortunate to partner with AAU, and they have multiple sports that they represent, and they're able to bring volleyball, basketball. We partner with USA Futsal. They bring indoor soccer here, and now we're in the game.
So you guys have all your own equipment.
One of the biggest challenges with sports directors bringing tournaments here was shipping courts. Now we have the courts here, we eliminated that obstacle, and we are proud to say that we host about 9 tournaments a year now.
Wow.
Multiple sports, and we can honestly say that we're the only facility in the state of Hawaii that can hold multiple sporting events all under one roof.
Nice. Yes. So we're gonna try our hand at some basketball right now.
Yes. Okay. I'm sure you're gonna hit the hoops.
Let's get our game on. Well, thank you for having me here today.
Thank you for coming to our beautiful convention center. We appreciate it.
I did not think we would be doing all that we did here. It's a one-stop shop.
It is. You can get so many things done here. Meetings, sports events, and a little fun.
And a little fun. Thanks. Thank you.
Thanks, Brooke.
I had so much fun with Terry on the basketball courts. Who knew we could do all of that in heels? Power to the women. Now we're headed out to the windward side to catch up with the Venice Health Castle and hear an inspiring story. Take a look.
I'm here at Adventist Health Castle with Dr. Jamala Munir. Hello.
Hi.
We're in your neck of the woods because this is cardiology.
Yes.
And you're an interventional cardiologist. Did I say that right?
Yes, that's correct.
What does that mean?
So I'm a cardiologist, so I'm a heart doctor. But the interventional part means that I treat heart attacks and I put in stents. To open up blockages in heart arteries.
Got it. But you're really big into prevention, right?
Yes, definitely, because the best thing to do instead of having to treat heart disease and having to have invasive procedures and take lots of medications is really to prevent it before it even starts.
You're kind of new here, but not really.
Yeah, that's right.
Because you have a history here in Hawaii. Right?
Yes, that's right. So I've currently only been on island for about 2 months.
Ooh, welcome again.
Thank you. But I first came to Hawaii with the Army. I was on active duty and got all my medical training through the military. I was on active duty for 17 years.
Wow.
And I was fortunate enough to spend 9 of those years on island.
Mm.
And then went to Virginia for a couple years, and then I wasn't done with Hawaii. I love it here.
Hawaii was calling.
It was calling
come
me,
back.
And I had to come back home. So, so we came back this summer, and it's been great coming back here and coming in and being connected to the Windward side. And we live in Kailua, and my kids go to school in Kailua, and now I'm get to practice in Kailua. So it's a great, great community here.
Awesome, awesome. So when we're talking about heart disease, especially like for women, because evidently it's a little different when it presents in women sometimes than men. Can you talk about that?
Definitely. So heart disease in general, we're talking about blockages in the heart arteries, which is usually caused by cholesterol and plaque buildup in the arteries. And in general, women and men will present very similarly with a chest discomfort, tightness, squeezing, aching, heaviness in the chest. Occasionally, even instead of in women presenting with blockages in the heart arteries, they can actually have just a tear in the artery, and we call that a spontaneous coronary dissection. And a dissection is just a tear in the artery, and it can present like a heart attack, but when we look in there, you know, it's not caused by cholesterol and plaque buildup. It's something to do with the hormones and stress that women have.
So what can people do to sort of stave off heart disease?
So prevention is the key, and the best thing to do is stop smoking.
Yes.
If you smoke, increase our physical activities. You know, our society has gotten to the point where we've made ourselves very comfortable in getting in our cars and driving places and sitting at desk and typing everywhere and watching TV and smartphones, and we're not moving the way that we used to. And so physical inactivity is very important, is a big risk factor for heart disease, and we want to get people moving. So, you know, even adding in 10 minutes a day after every meal, if you do that after breakfast, lunch, and dinner, you've got 30 minutes each day, and now you've added in some more activity.
So I wanted to ask you a little bit about plant-based diet. What would you suggest are some ways people could sort of supplement their diet by opting out of meat like 3 times at every meal?
Right. So it's great because in Hawaii we've got fresh fruits and vegetables. You know, even frozen vegetables are good. So trying to add in as many greens into whatever our diet is. Beans are very important because they have a high fiber content, and the fiber is amazing. That not only does it help with our elimination, but it helps to eliminate cholesterol in our body, and it can lower your blood pressure. You know, any type of beans that you like, try to see how you can add those into each meal.
Well, thank you so much, Dr. Munir.
Thank you for having me.
Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. We're here at Inspiration at Kapolei Commons talking about sports today.
Yes.
So these are like recliners that are excellent to watch any sporting event, really, I would think, because of the accoutrement, correct?
Exactly, yes.
So what are we talking about?
The wonderful thing about these huge sectionals is that we carry them in fabric, in different colors of leather, and then also they're modular. If you have a shorter wall on this side and a longer one on this side, we can build it so that it'll fit your whole living room. so that you can really maximize the space.
So you don't have to get this and hope it fits. You could just customize it
exactly
to fit your whatever location that you're doing your sports gathering at.
Exactly.
That's genius.
Yes.
That's genius.
So, and that's the lovely thing about them is hopefully once you invite your friends and your family over, you'll grab your drinks, your popcorn,
right,
and you'll just be here for the rest of the day.
Let's talk about the popcorn and the drinkability factor, because some people get a little bit excited during the games.
Yes.
Might spill maybe something here and there. What is that? Are we killing people when that happens on these couches, or is it pretty easy to clean?
It's pretty easy to clean. I mean, definitely if you spill something liquid on fabric, mm-hmm. I would try to put maybe a little seltzer water on it as quickly as possible.
Right.
Dab it up with a sponge, mm-hmm. or with a rag. Leather's a bit easier to clean. You can typically just wipe it right off.
Right, right.
Because it is protected leather, most of our pieces.
Nice. Okay, so and then this, some magic happens. Doesn't some magic happen with these couches?
Yes, it is a recliner. So you want to try it out?
Let's get into it.
So Brooke actually has these lovely buttons on the side, uh-huh. that also comes with a USB port.
Oh.
So never fret, you don't even have to get up to charge your phone.
Game changer.
You just plug it right in, charge your phone. And you're there.
Run the world from this.
Exactly.
I think so.
My buttons are actually hidden on the side right here.
Okay, so we're side by side, so we don't have to fight over the chair.
Nope. Your headpiece actually reclines as well. Also power recliner, so just with the click of a button.
Right.
If you can't see from down here,
oh,
and your TV's a little bit lower,
right.
you just push it up.
So I really like the fabric. It's really, really soft, but it comes in other colors, right?
Comes in other colors of fabric, and then also different colors of leather.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, and then there are other types of this couch that have other kind of things that are attached to it, like cup holders and that kind
so,
of thing?
So yes, we actually have, we have so many different variations of the recliner, sectional, modular type couch.
Mm-hmm.
And then one actually has a little lip or an arm that comes down that has cup holders and a little tray right here so you can have it
that
right
helps.
In between you and your partner.
That's awesome. Well, thanks for sharing with us. Now people can have their sports and eat their popcorn too.
Exactly.
All in the comfort of
and
their
charge their phone.
And charge their phone.
And have their own personal comfortability.
See? Always there for us, Inspiration Interiors.
Yeah, we try to be.
Thanks, Julia.
Thank you.
I'd just like to thank Inspiration Interiors for all the wonderful tips. I learn something new every single time. Now, not far from Inspiration Interiors is Kolevalu Park, which is right around South Shore Market and Hokua. We caught up with Coach Sue and Super Soccer Stars, and the cuteness factor was through the roof. Take a look.
Hi, my name is Sue, and I am the owner of Amazing Athletes, Super Soccer Stars, and Little Medical School. I started Amazing Athletes 8 years ago. Amazing Athletes is an educational sports program specifically designed for preschoolers and elementary kids. We play 10 different sports: football, soccer, basketball, baseball, hockey, golf, lacrosse, tennis, volleyball, and track and field. And Super Soccer Stars is the sister company of Amazing Athletes. We started Super Soccer Stars 4.5 months ago. We've been doing free classes for our community in Kaka'ako Park. It's been really great. Kids have so much fun and we're so encouraged. Another program that I started 3 years ago is called Little Medical School. We want to encourage kids to love health science, inspire kids to be doctors and vets and nurses, pharmacists, because we don't have enough doctors in Hawaii. And we run 3 programs in private schools, public schools, and charter schools today. Super Soccer Stars is a youth soccer program. It's very unique. It's specifically targeting age 1 to 5. So 12 to 24 months, it's our kick and play program. We use music, puppets, shakers, animals and numbers to teach kids how to play soccer. And we have our 2.5 to 5-year-old soccer program. It's adventure-based, so kids really have fun as they learn basic soccer skills. We want to encourage them to keep trying, to never give up. So Super Soccer Stars is a 40-minute program. Very different from other soccer programs. It's a 40-minute session once a week, and we either come on to the schools or at the park, and we will go through a comprehensive curriculum where we start off with our warm-ups, our stretches, our obstacle courses, our athletic skills, our running skills, and so on. And then we go into soccer skills, ball control, dribble, passing, and shooting. Kids love it. So one of the key things we focus really is positive reinforcement. We want to keep encouraging the kids to keep trying, to keep doing better, right? As they build confidence, you know, they're going to be so much stronger. You're not just physically strong, but emotionally, you know, psychologically stronger, so that they can basically tackle any challenges in life. So our instructors are just amazing, passionate, you know, encouraging, and engaging all the time. So we teach with lots of energy, excitement, and just so much joy in the heart. So we really hope that you can join us. You can find us online at oahu.supersoccerstars.com, or you can check out our Facebook page, Super Soccer Stars Oahu. We run 4 classes per month, and you can sign up on a monthly basis. Our program runs year-round, and you can opt out anytime. And we really hope that you can join us and have fun with us. Thank you.
Well, that's our sporty show for you today. Can you believe I actually put a basket in a hoop in heels? Thank you so much to Terry Orton for everything that she's doing over at the Convention Center, for giving local sports people a chance to take it to the next level. That was completely inspirational. Thank you to Adventist Health Castle. Always such a joy to go out to the Windward side and catch up with them and all of the different people that they're showing us. It's an amazing, amazing opportunity. To Inspiration Interiors, my home away from home. Every week I learn new things about furniture, about design. I'm always excited to sit and talk with them. Also, I want to thank Super Soccer Stars, because you never know, the next Soccer Stars could be coming out of that little group that we saw at Kolovalu Park. They were so determined, they were so committed, and they were incredibly, incredibly cute. Don't forget to like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram at Modern Wahine Hawaii. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.
Modern Wahine Hawaii was filmed on location at Inspiration Interiors, Hawaii's best value in home furnishings.